everybody. We're here in Orangeburg, South Carolina at the Edisto
Memorial Gardens.
It's a place that we've always come to. It's close to home. And it's really beautiful. Lots of flowers and everything, especially the beginning of spring. So we thought we'd come down here and show you guys what we get to look at almost all the time when we come.
Nice little taste of the South. We got all these azaleas in bloom. We got moss hanging in the trees. Yeah, about 60, 70 miles further south, we'd be in Charleston.
Yeah.
So you get a little flavor of that up here. A beautiful place. If I look tired on this video, excuse me. I worked 12 hours last night. As of right now, I've been up for 26 hours straight, so.
He hasn't been to bed yet.
Don't plan on going to bed till 10 hours.
I don't know how he does it.
Energizer bunny.
Yeah. But we're going to turn this around so you can kind of see the gardens real quick. I'm just going to turn this way because it goes up the hill there as well. We just came down.
We'll also be going along the Edisto River and on the boardwalk.
We're coming down it's handicap accessible, so we're coming down the handicap ramp.
It does turn to dirt and grass as you get to the bottom. And according to the weather, if it's been raining, it can get a bit boggy in spots.
Yeah. This is a really beautiful place.
Of course, there's one of the trucks with the folks down here maintaining and keeping up the park.
A little muddy right there.
A lot of cypress mixed in amongst the flowers and shrubs. But it's most well known by the roses. Most people refer to it as the Rose Gardens.
Yeah.
Even though the official name is the Edisto Memorial Gardens. And there's a memorial at the entrance to the Vietnam War, World War II, Korean War. And today, I don't know if we'll see many roses. It's a little early in the year for that, but the azaleas are in bloom and the dogwoods.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a beautiful backdrop. A lot of folks come up here and do pictures and do photo shoots up here in this area. Really popular for that. Or just to come and hang out, find a place to sit and enjoy the beauty of the nature.
Mm-hmm. We've got plenty of birds and squirrels and cardinal. Mm-hmm. Is one of the main entrances to it right over here.
And of course, I said the roses aren't in bloom just yet, but just ahead you'll see a rose that is always in bloom. You can see it year round.
It's quite pretty. Yeah, there's all the rose bushes behind it.
I hear geese in the distance. Love the moss.
There's the geese right here, over there.
Yeah, they're over by the pond. I see a squirrel.
Where do you see him at?
He's right over there. He went behind that cypress. Oh, there he is.
That's a pretty little redbird over there with him.
Uh-huh. He's on a treasure hunt for what he buried over last fall.
There's several of them over there.
Mm-hmm. It's a hunting party.
There's geese. or to choose which way you go. Let's go this way first.
Okay.
And come back and get on the boardwalk.
Go over by the pond, look at the geese, probably a few turtles.
There's benches all throughout the place where you could sit and have lunch or just relax. It used to be swings over there, and they took that one down, looks like.
Yeah. There may still be a few throughout. It's been a little bit since we've been here.
Here is kind of muddy.
Yeah, it stays a little wet in here.
Might need to cross over right here. You went on up the tree.
Yep. We'll return and do another video as the roses are in full bloom. So you can get a view of that. There's quite a few out there.
Mm-hmm. A pretty little statue over there too. Mm-hmm. It's all the geese.
Apparently geese don't have GPS. They got lost on their way back to Canada. Or they just flew over and said, you know, this is a really beautiful place. Why don't we just set up shop here? All this flying, I mean, it's just... get exhausted. People come out here, they'll feed us. Got all kind of stuff here. You got a nice pond to swim in.
Walk this way. Hope they don't chase us.
Nah.
They're kind of mean. It's a pretty pond.
Mm-hmm. And if you go up over the bridge, there's a placard, or there used to be, of the different fish that are in the pond. There's a few mallards out here. An occasional wood duck. Let's see a few turtles popping their heads up out there in the pond.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Try to weed through the geese here. Oh. Water looks like it feels good. It's just bath time.
Mm-hmm. We got a really colorful one over here.
Colorful. I don't think I've ever seen a goose like that before.
It's not a goose.
Oh. It's a butterfly.
do it.
He waddles like a duck, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm. You said it walks like a duck? It waddles like a duck? It's a duck.
It must be a duck. Well, hey there. Oh, there they are. They're behind the tree.
Apparently, he thinks he's a goose.
Yeah, I think so too.
Hanging out.
Going his own little way. Well, hey there, fella. No, he says. He said, you can take my picture, but I'm not coming no closer. Mm-hmm. Pretty.
Taking away the placards to tell you what kind of fish were in here.
Oh.
But I want to say there were some grass carp and catfish and brim. Those are three I can definitely remember. You get to the top of the hill up here, we'll be walking alongside the Edisto River. And there's cypress swamp on both sides. And a nice boardwalk that takes you all the way down through the water.
Yeah, they have. Here's the boardwalk. Gonna take the ramp. I'm gonna look at the sign. Yeah.
The Wetlands Park.
He's taking the ramp, I'm taking the stairs. His knees bothering him.
The old water wheel could use some oil.
Mm-hmm. Water just flows down through there. It's cool and refreshing.
A bit snaky.
Yeah, I don't think I want to get in it. But.
And probably a gator or two. Turtles. And a lot of catfish.
I wonder if you can fish down here. Do they let you fish?
I know back there you can't, but.
Maybe further down here?
Maybe further down here you can. I'm not sure.
You can can fish down here, I wouldn't mind it. I just don't want to go back to the tail race with Dad because the gator, oh my gosh. He was under the boat and you could hear the bumpy things on his back and lifted up the boat. My dad thought it was funny that I got really scared till it did that. And he said, okay, it's time to go.
Mm-hmm. It starts moving the boat. That's a pretty big gator.
Mm-hmm. I done reeled my line in and put it back in the boat. I was ready to go. Looks like they repaired that one.
Yeah, it's quite a bit of damage a few years ago from a storm that came through.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the boardwalks were blocked off and you can only go to certain ones. But they've done a good job of coming down here and clearing away the debris and repairing some of the areas that were broken.
Kind of warm out here today.
It's really warm. Not too bad. Nice day for a relaxing walk.
Mm-hmm.
And if you watch the video on the Congaree, you'll notice some of the same trees, all the cypress. Another beautiful place just to go walk and relax.
Cute little puppy.
Thank you, buddy.
Hey!
Jacob.
Hello. Hi, he's adorable.
He's friendly.
Hi! Shall we love puppies?
Yeah.
He's so sweet.
Thank you. Draco. Yeah.
Happy little dog.
Mm-hmm. His name is Jacob.
Draco, I believe.
Draco?
Little cupboard area up here in case you get caught in the rain.
You can go back out there now, I think, too. It's out there by
the
road.
See how far we can venture.
Back around over there. Somebody just had a fender bender. Thought I heard a pow. You hit the back of that truck.
Thank you. And of course, if you're on the river on your boat, you can pull up along here and tie up and get out and walk around. And as you can tell from the mud on the boards, the river does rise and cover a lot of this area. I've also seen it when the water was so far down, you could hop down, there was sand down there you could walk on. It's at a good level right now. All right, well, we're headed back out.
See where it takes us around that way.
It takes us back out to the road. The grassy area out there.
We made it back from the
water wheel.
Other end of the boardwalk. Hello.
How you doing?
We're back around here where we started. Got a little too close for me.
They're just doing their job. Pollinating. There he is. Over there on that tree.
Mm-hmm.
Like little purple pods in the distance look like grapes.
Pretty. Hanging out of the trees.
Too close up. My head was like straight up and down.
Pretty red cardinal up there singing. Just like that, back where we started.
Yep. Walking by the river and all the trees, the cypress with the moss and everything, just always reminds me of one of my favorite movies, The Patriot with Mel Gibson. Imagine what it would have been like to have been back there in the Revolutionary War, hiding out in the swamps. Something really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the actual battles wouldn't have been. And
go back up there. Side of the road, you got your restrooms and a few more monuments and stuff.
I'm gonna walk this way a little bit. I can't really see around that bridge. Alright, ready?
Yeah. Pavilion over there. It's a fountain over there that they don't, it's not running right now. It's a pretty monument here. Angel Hope.
cool.
Have the water features going up here, but there's like some koi in that pond. Nice little thing. If it's raining, you come up here and get out of the rain.
Or the sun.
Yeah, sun too. This would be a nice photo op. There's usually water running all down through here.
Hopefully as we get closer to summer, it'll be running again. I said, I believe they shut it down during the winter time to keep from having to deal with frozen pipes and things of that nature. So now that we're creeping into spring, hopefully we have everything back up and running here pretty soon. Hopefully by the time the roses are in bloom, when we come back down for that, so that was our trip to Orangeburg, to the Edisto Memorial Gardens and Wetlands Park. And hope you enjoyed this walk and came along with us. Saw a little bit of nature, some beautiful birds and flowers and squirrels and geese and mallards. And what do you think about all that?
I really enjoyed it. It's peaceful.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it too.
I'd have petted the geese if they let me.
If you'd have had something to feed them, I believe they would have got close enough for you to pet them.
Yeah, I'll have to bring some bread next time.
Yeah.
But if you enjoyed it, make sure you give us a thumbs up, comment down below what you thought of the place, and thank you for joining us today. Like he said, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Hit that notification bell so that you'll know when one's coming up. And until next time,
keep dreaming.
Bye, everybody.